LEGO's movie tie-in games like LEGO Star Wars and LEGO Indiana Jones take their source material and retell their stories through the medium of interlocking Scandinavian blocks, which, I'll be honest, is sometimes a massive improvement. So that's what that film was missing. However, the LEGO games are aimed squarely at a younger audience, and so often, when they're recreating a scene from a movie that was violent or scary or horrifying in some way, the LEGO version of that scene will be toned down and played for laughs, so as not to upset the kids. Well, except for the Star Wars scene where Han Solo shoots Greedo. This is somehow much worse. Brutal. Just consider these traumatic movie moments that the good folks at LEGO toned down for their blocky adaptations. Enjoy, and beware spoilers for the following games and their corresponding movies. Also for what happens to Greedo in Star Wars. Terrible business, that. In the Indiana Jones film Raiders of the Lost Ark, Indy is searching for the Ark of the Covenant, a wooden box that, according to various books of the Bible, contains the two stone tablets of the Ten Commandments, Moses' brother Aaron's walking stick, and a pot of manna, the supernatural foodstuff God gave to the Israelites during their journey through the desert. According to Raiders of the Lost Ark, however, the Ark of the Covenant also contains something else. Scary, screaming ghosts, and energy beams that melt your face right off your goddamn skull! It's quite the thing, and anyone who saw Raiders of the Lost Ark at a young age will no doubt remember this scene because it was the only thing you saw when you closed your eyes at night for the next 6 to 8 weeks. As such, you can see why the makers of the LEGO games would want to tone this scene down so as to avoid traumatizing kids into not buying the accompanying face-melting LEGO playset. In this version of the scene, the ghosts the Ark sends out are notably cheerier, and instead of being pierced with holy lasers and exploding, the Nazis just pop apart into their constituent LEGO bricks. Main bad guy Tote goes a bit wonky, but thankfully we're spared the sight of his entire face liquefying and sliding off his skull like we see in the movie. The movie set a really high bar, is what I'm saying. And now I'm remembering that scene again, and it's going to be a really fun 6 to 8 weeks.
One of the original Jurassic Park movie's most important scenes is also one of its most traumatizing. The opening scene of the movie, recreated as the opening level in the game LEGO Jurassic World, involves a velociraptor being transferred into its pen via an oversized version of those carriers you use to take your cat to the vet. And let me tell you, the velociraptor likes it about as much as your cat does. As you'll remember from the film, this poor park employee, Geoffrey Brown, falls off the top of the container as he's releasing the gate and is dragged into it by an angry velociraptor, like he's being fed into a giant paper shredder. This scene is so important as it kicks off the events of the rest of the movie. It's the reason the lawyers and experts are called in to verify the safety of Jurassic Park, lol. And also by extension, the reason why beloved characters like Alan Grant, Ellie Sattler, and Ian Malcolm are still showing up in Jurassic Park movies today.
You coming or what?
Well, that and presumably an enormous guaranteed paycheck. All this makes it a bit strange then, that in the game LEGO Jurassic World's retelling, Geoffrey does fall off the container, but the velociraptor is far more interested in stealing the giant comedy frankfurter he's been waving around. Now, you'd imagine that the legal team wouldn't bother investigating the disappearance of this one guy's hot dog unless it was made of unicorn meat or something. Except, lawyer Donald Gennaro does still show up to the island with Drs. Grant, Sattler, and Malcolm in tow, risking life and limb in the process. Maybe it was unicorn meat. Damn, those geneticists are good.
This is S.H.I.E.L.D.?
This is what S.H.I.E.L.D.'s supposed to be.
This is not so bad.
Let's load him up.
In the Avengers movies, Quicksilver is Pietro Maximoff, Scarlet Witch's brother and possessor of both incredible speed powers and a superhero outfit that looks like the costume department bought it from Sports Direct the morning of filming. Anyway, someone high up at Marvel decided that we needed a death to up the stakes in Age of Ultron, and unlucky Quicksilver was the one chosen to sacrifice himself, saving, of all people, Hawkeye. I know! Quicksilver sprints in front of Hawkeye as he is about to be riddled with bullets, taking the bullets himself, and dying in a way that absolutely wouldn't fly in a kid's game. So, as a replacement, we instead get this scene in which Hawkeye is trying to save a pig, rather than a small child, and is standing in front of an ice cream truck. Now, Quicksilver dashes in front of Hawkeye and somehow ends up covered in ice cream instead of blood, although the end result is the same.
You didn't see that coming.
Apart from the bit where the pig eats some of the ice cream. That's new.
You'd have thought, after the whole Ark of the Covenant face-melting farrago, the Nazis of the Indiana Jones series would have worked out not to F with ancient religious relics. Yet by Indiana Jones and the Last Crusade, they found another potentially dangerous artifact to chase after. This time it's the Holy Grail, allegedly the cup that Jesus drank from during the Last Supper, and the one that was used to catch his blood during the crucifixion. Were they hoping to put it back in him? Because it feels a little bit late for that. In the fiction of Indiana Jones, the Grail confers eternal life and can heal all wounds. But when everyone shows up to the Temple of the Sun, it turns out there are a series of tests to pass before you reach the Grail Sanctuary. They include correctly spelling the name of God, taking a leap of faith onto an invisible bridge, and kneeling before God to avoid whirling saw blades. Which seems a bit harsh given that Lego minifigs don't even have knees. Once you eventually reach the chamber where the Grail is guarded by an ancient Knight Templar, the final catch is that you have to select it from rows of similar-looking cups. Nazi collaborator Walter Donovan has first dibs, so he picks a Grail, chooses poorly, and if you've ever seen the movie, you won't be able to erase the vivid, harrowing memory of him aging approximately 2,000 years in a matter of moments. Which is exactly what happens to me when someone explains the latest TikTok trend to me. I'm trying so hard, I just don't get it. In the video game, it's a bit more like he suddenly dons a cheap Skeletor Halloween outfit, smashes his head against the table a few times, and then abruptly pops into his component parts. Not at all harrowing. Look how unharrowed I remain. They took another stab at this scene in LEGO Indiana Jones 2, The Adventure Continues. But if you're expecting it to crank up the horror, you'll be sorely disappointed when Donovan inexplicably turns into a giant tornado monster and... is this Nazi-sympathising baddie laughing? He's having a great time! Quick, someone explain TikTok to him!
Dennis, our lives are in your hands and you have butterfingers?
I'm totally unappreciated in my time.
You know anybody who can network 8 connection machines and debug 2 million lines of code for what I bid for this job?
Jurassic Park fans will remember Dennis Nedry. He's the nerdy computer programmer who attempts to smuggle dinosaur embryos off the island hidden in a fake can of shaving foam, and who deactivates most of the park's security to do so. Doesn't go well, as you can imagine. Nedry himself meets a literally sticky end as a result of his subterfuge when his jeep slides off the road in heavy rain and he is confronted by a Dilophosaurus, which spits sticky, tar-like venom into his eyes and then mauls him to death in his jeep. Generally, the number of brutal maulings that parents want in their children's video games is zero, and so Dennis Nedry's fate in the Jurassic Park portion of the LEGO Jurassic World game is markedly different to how it is in the movie. Some things are the same. Dennis still gets spat at and is still cornered by the Dilophosaurus in his jeep, but in this version, Dennis is able to jam a chicken leg in its mouth and make a run for it, leaving the dino thrashing around inside on its own. Oh, so you'll change that, but you won't do up LEGO Jeff Goldblum's shirt, LEGO Jurassic World. Yeah, I see how it is.
Anakin! If you're not with me, then you're my enemy!
The path of Anakin Skywalker, from pod-racing infant to mighty Sith Lord to eventual Force Ghost, is one punctuated by horror and tragedy. But for events that are both horrific and tragic, it's hard to beat the iconic duel in Episode 3 between Anakin Skywalker and his former master Obi-Wan on Mustafar, a volcanic planet that is one enormous permanent game of the floor is lava. And we all know who loses that game. To turn the duel between Obi-Wan and Anakin into a proper LEGO game level, LEGO Star Wars the video game expands the climactic confrontation by turning it into a running battle, where Anakin retreats through a series of blast doors and waits while Obi-Wan and C-3PO solve environmental puzzles, so Obi-Wan can catch up with him and resume the fight. Finally though, the two duelists come together, and then the battle more closely resembles the bit in the movie. A bit which ends, you surely remember, with Obi-Wan chopping off 3 out of 4 of Anakin's limbs, then leaving his former student being burned up by one of Mustafar's famous lava flows in presumably unimaginable pain. If you don't remember it, that means you've traumatically repressed probably the most horrifying image in all of this dismemberment-heavy franchise. Good for you!
It's over, Anakin! I have the high ground!
The LEGO reimagining of this graphic scene benefits from how the arms and legs of LEGO minifigures pop off easily with minimal violence. And also spares you the horror of actually seeing Anakin burning alive, which is nice.
I hate you!
In the LEGO version of the story, Anakin is still rescued by Palpatine and subjected to a grim transformation into Darth Vader, but the horror tragedy is offset by a visual gag where he has one arm replaced with a chicken leg. Another one? Those things get everywhere!
Of Gondor.
Boromir.
If you had to pick a member of the Fellowship of the Ring who least understood the brief, you'd probably pick Boromir. The one who tried to forcefully steal the ring from Frodo and who then runs around looking for him so he can apologise and then gets killed trying to hold off the orcs to save Merry and Pippin, who end up kidnapped anyway. He's desperate to make his dad proud and save his city, so hopefully his dad is extremely impressed by people who can't even steal a ring from a hobbit and who get shot full of orc arrows.
Dunking on Boromir!
Alright, fine. Anyway, as you'd imagine, Boromir's death in LEGO The Lord of the Rings differs somewhat to the one seen in the movie, as no one wants to see a cute little LEGO Sean Bean get pincushioned by barbed arrows. He does start off getting hit by one, but then pulls it out and throws it aside, apparently with no ill effects. The orc follows this up with a broom, which has a bit of ill effect, but that Boromir is also able to cast aside. What finally does for Boromir in this version is, of course, a banana? A banana. Okay. And the orc leader looks set to finish the job with a chicken before Aragorn steps in to make the save just in time. Which Boromir is delighted about, before realising he has a banana in him and dying. On the plus side, LEGO The Lord of the Rings used dialogue from the movie for all its cutscenes, so you get to listen to Viggo Mortensen and Sean Bean doing their serious acting while looking at a LEGO Boromir with a banana sticking out of his chest, which I've got to tell you is a real treat.
I would have followed you, my brother. My captain. My king.
God, I wish J.R.R. Tolkien could see this. Just to see the look on his face.
No. No.
Thanks for watching this video about movie moments that were traumatic in the movie, but then the LEGO games were like, this is for kids, we can't show a guy's face sliding off his skull. What are you thinking, George Lucas? How did you get in here? Why are you insisting we program it in?
He won't leave.
He won't get, someone get this man out of here. What, security? Oh no, the security are all stormtroopers from Star Wars. they've taken over. I guess George Lucas is in charge now and we've got to put it in. That's a real thing that happened. And another real thing that can happen is you watching more videos by Outside Xbox and Outside Extra. Up here is a video from us that we had to tone down. It was really raunchy before, but now it's just video games. And down here is a video from Outside Extra, which includes LEGO Lord of the Rings, which you can't buy anymore because of legal issues. So you can find out why by watching that video. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time. Bye.